Hello children, I welcome you all to the teaching learning platform of subject English, class 9. Today we will study a very beautiful poem, a personification of when by Subramanya Bharati. To begin with, Subramanya Bharati was a Tamil social reformer, a journalist and a great poet. He kindled nationality and patriotism in the lives of people. So let's begin with the poem where the central idea of the poem is to let us know about the destructive aspect of wind, that how nature can be destructive and what could be the outcome of it. The main theme of the poem is that the poet wants us to know that how destructive powers of the wind, they stand for adversities in our life, and how actually must we stand tall to these adversities and face the challenges of life. Okay, so now let's begin with stanza 1. First I'm going to recite the poem and then we'll be doing with the explanation. Wind, come softly. Don't break the shutters of the windows. Don't scatter the papers. Don't throw the books down the shelf. There, look, what you did. You threw them all down. You tore the pages of the books. You brought rain again. So now what is the tone of the poet? Here, the poet is instructing the wind. What is he doing? He is personifying the wind. The wind has been personified. And what is he requesting him to do? He is requesting wind to come softly, means it mustn't blow hard. It is very windy, so what is it asking? Not to blow fast. Don't break the shutters of the window. So these are all the destructive aspects of the wind. See, what has wind done? It has broken the shutters of the window. It has scattered the papers. What is scatter means? To spread here and there. Don't throw the books down the shelf. And now what has it done? The wind has thrown the books down the shelf. There. Look, what you did. Now here, the poet is instructing the wind. What is he saying? Look, what you did. And what has the wind done? You threw them all down. What has been thrown down? The books from the shelf. You tore the pages of the book. Tore. Tear, tore, torn. Okay, means tearing away. You tore the pages of the books. You brought rain again. Now here, what is the poet trying to do? He is instructing the wind. He has personified the wind, and now he is instructing the wind to not to have that destructive quality in it. It is calling him again and again to stop its destructive aspect so that things may be calm. Now come on to the figures of speech, beta. Now let's come on to the figures of speech. Wind, come softly. Don't break the shutters of the window. Don't scatter the papers. Don't throw the books down. This is anaphora. Repeating of don't again and again in the lines is anaphora. And then next, what are we learning is personification. Where we can see that the wind has been personified. It is addressing the wind. The poet, he is addressing the wind. Don't do this. Don't do that. So it's giving it a human trait. That is why it is personification. And the entire poem is with no rhyming scheme. That is, it is a blank verse. Okay, so let's proceed further with the second stanza. Now the poet further says that you're very clever at poking fun at weaklings. Now what is the poet saying to wind? He's saying that wind, you are very clever, you're very smart. And what is the wind smart at? Poking fun, ridiculing. Poking fun means ridiculing at the weaklings, weak people. Fray means weak. Crumbling means breaking houses. Crumbling doors. Again, crumbling means breaking. Crumbling windows. Rafters, what are rafters? Rafters are logs used in roof. Crumbling wood. Crumbling bodies. Crumbling lives. So what is the poet trying to say here? The entire poem is a metaphor for adversities in life. And what is the poet trying to say? That wind, it only disturbs the weakling. It makes fun of the weaklings. It ridicules the weakling. And how does it ridicule the weaklings? By the crumbling, by impacting the crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling life, and crumbling hearts, means broken hearts. The real motive of the poet is to let us know is that people who are weak, who are not able to face the adversities of life, they fall victim to the adversities. Okay, so this is why the word crumbling, which is a repetition as a figure of speech, has been highlighted again and again. And the entire poem, the poem Wind by Subramanya Bharti, is a metaphor and symbolism, a symbol of adversities and the challenges of life, and how actually must we stand tall to bear these adversities, and if we give up, we give up to life. So beautifully the poet is letting us know that by repeating the word, repetition of the word crumbling, that the wind is crumbling everything that is weak. It is breaking everything that is weak. Okay. And it is putting an end to them. Now look at the last line, the wind god. It is personification. The wind god winnows them on. Winnows is sifting. What is winnows? You sift. You sift husk from rice. It's a scientific term, winnowing. And crushes them all. The wind god, it cleans everything. The frail, the broken pieces are sifted, and the brave and the ones with a lot of power, they remain in life. This is what is the intention of the second paragraph, which has been explained in the poem. Again, I tell you that the entire poem is a blank verse with no rhyming scheme. Now let's come on to stanza 3. Now here the poet Subramanya Bharti is in a suggestive mood. So what is he suggesting us to do? He won't do what you tell him. Now who is he here? He is the wind here. So wind has been personified here again. He won't do, the wind would not do what you tell him. He will not listen to our instructions. The wind would not behave in the way as we want. So come. So here the suggestion starts. So what is he suggesting? What is he suggesting us to do? So come, let's build strong homes. Rather than complaining and falling victim to the wind, what must we do? We must build strong homes. The crumbled houses must be repaired and built strong. Let's join the doors firmly. Rather than getting them crumbled and fall down, we must make our doors firm so that they do not fall. Practice to firm the body. What must we practice? We must practice to make our body strong. That means physically and mentally we are fit. Make the heart steadfast means make the heart strong. It should not go with the adversity. It must be steadfast. It must be made strong. Do this. And if we do this, and the wind will be friend with us. If we do this, the wind is surely going to be friend with us. So the entire poem, the entire paragraph is a symbolism and a metaphor to the adversities of life. Blows out weak fires. So what does the poet say now? That the wind, it blows off people, it takes away people or fires, it blows off fires that is weak. So weak here is an adjective and fire is a noun. So a noun followed by adjective is a transverb epithet. He made strong fires roar and flourish. Now he here again is personification. The wind is given the quality of a human being. So it is personification. What does the wind do? He makes strong fires roar and flourish. People who are strong, they prosper, they shout and flourish. His friendship is good. Friendship of strong people is always good. Why? Because they bring us strength and agility. We praise him every day. So because the wind is strong, we praise wind every day. So now what is the learning outcome of the poem? The learning outcome of the entire metaphor is we must make ourselves strong enough to face up the adversities and challenges in life. Dear children, the resources to the chapter, that is the PPT, the assignments and the YouTube links have been provided to you on your ERP. Kindly check